Very good morning to all of you and welcome back to our first Sunday session Kunj Bhogwala Borsal. Right? So today again we are back with our very interesting subject, that is English, along with the interesting, our interesting story. Right? Yesterday we have talked, but we have discussed the story about the scholar's mother tongue, right? Pandit. Now let's revise what was there, right? Before we move further. So we have seen till now that there was a Pandit, you know, he was very fluent in different languages. He knew many languages. So nobody knew that what was his mother tongue. We all have our mother tongue, right? In which we can communicate with our people, right? And but obviously, since it is our mother tongue, it is very comfortable for us to communicate very easily, right? And we are very fluent in our mother tongue. Same way, the Pandit was also very comfortable, you know, to communicate, and even he was very fluent in speaking the other languages. So once he went to the king's palace, right? Akbar, the king Akbar, and he told to the king and even the courtiers that I am master in various languages. You know, I have mastery on different languages. And he challenged everybody along with, you know, the king that find out my mother tongue if you can. That was the challenge. Now as the king was there, so he told to his courtiers that I don't want to listen anything, you just find out what is his mother tongue, right? That was all about the challenge. And the courtiers, the people who were sitting over there, right? They tried a lot, they started searching, they, you know, they applied various methods to come to know that which would be the mother of Pandit. But since Pandit was very fluent in different languages, so it was too tough for the courtiers even to find out which was his mother tongue. So finally what happened? In the last, Birbal, the witty person, a very intelligent person, he accepted that challenge, right? And now he is going to do something through which he came to know, or you know, he's gonna come to know that what is Pandit's mother tongue, right? So up to now we have discussed, we have learned. Now let's move further. That night, Birbal went quietly to the Pandit's room when he was asleep. When all discussions were going on in the daytime, Birbal accepted the challenge, right? And he thought something. He decided something. So what he did that night, the day when he accepted the challenge, he thought, and that night, Birbal went quietly, very quietly, right? Slowly, slowly, very quietly, went where? To the Pandit's room when he was asleep. To the Pandit's room, right? Where he was sleeping very nicely. He whispered into the Pandit's ear and tickled it with a feather. He whispered into the Pandit's ear, right? Whispered. Whispered means tell him something very quietly in the ear, right? That nobody can listen. Not another person can listen. That is whispered. So he whispered into the Pandit's ear, something he whispered, right, into the Pandit's ear and tickled it with a feather. Now when he took one feather and started tickling, right? Started tickling, as you can see in the textbook, right? Started tickling it with a feather, with the help of feather, right? The Pandit half awake. So now as he was very nicely sleeping, right? But as Birbal whispered in his ear, when he started tickling with the feather, the Pandit half awake. So now he had opened his eyes, but he was not fully awake, right? He was half awake. Cried out suddenly. Now as he got disturbance in his sleep, so but obvious he got angry. So cried out suddenly and shouted. He got angry and started shouting. Shouting out words in his mother tongue. So now what happened? He got angry. Started shouting, but in which language? In his mother tongue, right? In his mother tongue. See the whole situation. Birbal went into the Pandit's room when he was asleep, whispered something in the ear, and started tickling with the feather everywhere, right? So, what happened? He got disturbed. He was entering his sleeping. So now he got disturbed. So what he did? He cried, got angry and shouted. Shouting in his mother tongue. Now see, in the next paragraph, Birbal came to the court the next day. The whole incident had taken place in the room. On the very next day, Birbal came to the court the next day and told everyone that the Pandit's mother tongue was Telugu. Right? Telugu. It's a language, right? Spoken in our country, Telugu, right? Birbal came to the court next day. He came to the court next day and he told everyone that listen to me. I want to tell you something. Now as you try to find the Pandit's mother tongue, but you are failed. But yesterday I did something and I got to know the mother tongue of this Pandit. Right? And what he did? He said that Pandit's mother tongue is Telugu. Though he speaks all the languages very fluently, but his mother tongue is Telugu. The Pandit was surprised and accepted the truth. Now, the Pandit, he challenged everybody that find out my mother tongue. Through these words of Birbal, that his mother tongue was Telugu, the Pandit was surprised. Huh? How he had come to know that Telugu is my mother tongue? And yes, he accepted that yes, everybody, my mother tongue is Telugu. Now, the last lines, the Pandit was surprised and accepted the truth, right? So the thing is that everybody was eager to know that how Birbal had found his mother tongue, right? So what he said, let's see in our another paragraph. students, this is the end of this video, right? I hope that first and second part you have enjoyed. Now the climax is remaining, right? So that last scene we will see in our next video, right? Then what exactly we will have done, right? To come to know the mother tongue of the Pandits, right? So till then, you take very good care of yourself.